Dresden skyline, as seen from the Elbe River meadows, is the most famous view of the city. Sometimes Ekkehard Tischendorf takes a stroll beside the magnificent Baroque buildings. The Brühl Terrace is the most popular place for taking walks. Dresden is Ekkehard Tischendorf's hometown. He was born here, he lives here, and the 34-year-old artist works here. He cherishes what the city has to offer.
It's well known, and we needn't pretend otherwise. Today, the young generation likes to move to Berlin. I don't think that's necessary. We have to give a place like this a chance. The question is, which parameters do you seek for your work? I think Dresden is definitely a place that really offers wonderful conditions for creativity.
One of Dresden's most important museums reopened in June 2010. The Albertinum, with art from the Romantic period to the present. The former inner courtyard is now roofed over. The art depot that was in the cellar until the flood 8 years ago is now stored here.
The depository, which was severely damaged by the flood in 2002, has been raised, so to speak, literally put on high as a Noah's Ark project. And above us are the Albertinum storage rooms and restoration workshops.
The Albertinum has a large sculpture collection, as well as the Gallery of New Masters. The tour begins with works by Caspar David Friedrich. Each room is devoted to a particular era or painter. The works by Gerhard Richter, however, take up two rooms. The famous Dresden painter donated many of his works to the city, but demanded in return that the museum be remodeled.
This was one of his conditions. If he gave so many works to the city, then it had to build something new.
Ekkehard Tischendorf's studio is in Hellerau, an artist's district in northern Dresden. Tischendorf is successful. He recently showed work at the Art Basel Fair. His gallery in Hamburg reports solid interest in his work. Tischendorf's pictures often have garish colors.
I reach almost automatically for this neon color, in this case primarily magenta. It's provocative. It provides the search for an illuminating aspect in the picture, for a sort of magical light, as you could call it.
Dresden's Residenzpalace has been almost completely rebuilt. Gradually, the treasures of Saxony's 18th-century ruler Augustus the Strong have been returning here. The Turkish Chamber, which reopened in March 2010, has been another magnet for visitors. It shows one of the oldest and most important collections of Ottoman art in the world.
This is riding equipment of special magnificence. Nowhere else has this much of it, and in such a complete condition. Not even in Turkey.
The exhibits include decorated horses and weapons, as well as a three-pole Ottoman tent, 20 meters long and 8 meters wide, made of gold and silk.
Dresden is a city that collects old cultural treasures. That still holds true and must remain one of our foundations.
Increasingly, new treasures are joining the old in Dresden, a city that inspires young artists to add to its riches.